Yeah, you hear that correctly. This is an Suzo Arcade Turbo with a micro switch fire button. I've always speculated that these would possibly exist, and it turns out to be true. I recently bought my third Suzo Arcade Turbo joystick. The first two ones I've already shown in a previous video. That was a couple of years back in 2012 when I did my review and comparison of various Suzo joysticks. And I mentioned that the Arcade Turbo joystick that I had had leaf switches. For instance, that was this one, in fact. This one has a leaf switch. And the other one, this one, also has a leaf switch. But it turns out that Arcade Turbos with a micro switch fire button actually exist. So yeah, I'd say let's crack it open. There are some interesting observations here. First off, the rubber pads are missing, but that's just the way I bought it. And also, this has the really interesting black rubber and a production sticker, so we can date it. So let's crack it open. So open it up and we'll see that. This here is the very nice higher quality black rubber inside. Just like with the very early Suzo Arcade units, the later joysticks have a white rubber that is kind of stiff and a little bit brittle. And this is nice and soft. So that's my first observation here. That indicates that we're dealing with a very early unit, in fact. And, well, here's the proof of the pudding. Here is the fire button micro switch. And also this board happens to be a very early one, as it does not have the holes for the leaf switch option. Another interesting thing is that this connector here already is the connected version. I'm not sure if there are Suzo Arcade Turbos that actually have the wires directly soldered to the board as with the original arcade joystick. I expect this is probably already from the first version of the Arcade Turbo, as this joystick was released in 1984. I've seen a copyright date on the boxes that I've saw on some pictures on the internet, so I know that Suzo released the Arcade Turbo in 1984. And well, this is an early unit because there's a date sticker inside. As you can see, this one is manufactured in June of 1985. It has the date sticker and yeah, it clearly says 85. So yeah, it's an early unit. The arcade joysticks were just out for a year. And there's also a few more things here. Let's see. What does it say? Hey, that's interesting. This little mark here, I hope the camera can pick it up, says 8412. So this plastic shell was manufactured in the 12th month, I think, of 1984. And well, it was put together or tested in June of 85, so that makes sense. There's about 6 months between them. And yeah, this is the board with the micro switch instead of the leaf switch. And everything else is pretty much the same. This has always been a leaf switch, as you can see. And the board number is 22-26-30. So maybe we should crack open a leaf switch version for comparison. So if we look inside, this is the version with the leaf switch, as you can see here. And it also has the extra holes here for the micro switch. And it also has the connector here. And this is the one that was inspected by Mr. IVR in May of 1988. Or it could also be the fifth week of 1988, I'm not sure. And this particular case, let's see, was made in Yeah, 1987 in the 8th month or August 87. So it was like 4 years old when this thing came out of its injection molding. And the bottom of the board also has a different number here. This is 22-26-31. So this clearly indicates that we're dealing here with a revision. As you can see, here's a comparison of the model numbers or the revision numbers. So I think that's quite an interesting observation here. It turns out there is a microswitch version of the Arcade Turbo, and it's just an earlier revision, or just an initial version of it. And I think, I expect, I and I suspect that they kind of revised the joystick somewhere around 1986, 87, when they released the Prof Competition. The Prof Competition 9000 was released in 1986, and it was the first one to have the dreaded leaf switches. And the successor, the deluxe version, was released in 1987. I also figured out, again through seeing photos of product packaging, that around 1990 they updated the design of the packaging of the regular arcade joystick, and it clearly says copyright 1990, and that's about the point that they started using plastic sticks instead of metal cores. So I think that they sort of started to cheapen out on the components around that time. But yeah, this is just some information that I didn't know a few years ago, but I have managed to gather in the past couple of years. So that one is put back together. And yeah, let's just have a final glimpse at this early revision model. And I will also make a few photos of it with some more details of this. Oh, I didn't put it back together correctly. Let's see. I didn't do this right. It should go this way. Because, of course, this thing has to switch. And, oh, actually. Ah! Stupid me! This is the wrong one. I switched them up! How stupid! I have to take it apart again. I switched up the cases. So, I got the right case half here. As you can see by the black one, I accidentally mixed them up. Yeah, very stupid of me. So, let's reassemble this one. Well, actually, the case halves, they don't kind of fit nicely. As you can see, there's some kind of, well, cracking here, I guess. So, there you have it. That was a look at the Arcade Turbo with microswitch fire button. I hope you found that useful, and well, thanks for watching.